Hello everybody, I'm Sneaky Gamer and welcome back to Spelunky. Let's see if I can actually get some good runs in today. Gotten a couple of pretty good ones recently, but they're mostly just surrounded by a bunch of really bad failures. I hope there isn't a spike down below that. At this point, how much? All of those come from. That's enough to get it, but can I get back up to it? I can't. That another shop is going to have it on the way down here. Bro, probably pretty slim. Yeah, it's probably best to just do that anyway. Give me one second. Of course, the gold got destroyed. Because why wouldn't it? I should have thought of that. Man, why am I so bad today? Just too distracted with this shit right now, I think. That was my last bomb. Should have paid more attention. It's not like this run was gonna go anywhere anyway. I mean, granted, I could still get more, but this might not hit him. That makes no fucking sense. Both her and that pot should have been destroyed. Both gotten squish. Okay, she's fine to jump down there. Okay. Hopefully I didn't just hit her in the head with that. But I did it. Honestly, I was pretty sure I was boned there, but I pulled it off, so. Somewhere I'm not going to be able to do that. And there's not. Oh, lovely. Oh, fine. You get to stay there and just die in the cave then. Back to our standard 4 hearts. That's interesting to find out where that happens. well. The environmental storytelling there does a good job. He's not in his place, she's gone, and there's leaves everywhere. One of the man-eater flowers came and killed her, he killed it. And that's all that's left then. Or, what, man-trap, I think the flowers were called, wasn't it? I was too close. Well, I would have got caught by that tiki trap on the way up if I tried to climb out anyway, so. Why did the spider not trigger that? If I can get that cup, I can make up the health pretty quickly. I haven't seen a chest with a bomb in it for quite a while. Of course she was up above, not down here. Fuck. Okay. think I need 2 living sacrifices in order to get the cup. I don't know how many dead ones I would need. Because the dead sacrifices, you need more than living sacrifices. Why did I try to jump that direction? It's always nice to find a surplus right away. I do have to address it. What happened is I tried to run and jump, and I pressed over before I jumped, so I ran off the edge of it. I was just a little too close to the edge, and I ran straight off the side onto the spikes. It was nice I got the paste right away, though. One of these days, I'll stop making the stupid mistakes of dying to spikes and shit like that. Or the ones where I run into a spider. Or a snake. I don't know how many drops of blood it takes when you get that cup to get an extra heart, but you just gotta collect drops of blood. I could say that was intentional, that I was right outside of the range of getting hit by that, but that was a total fucking accident. That's definitely worth it. Not sure where the damsel was in that level, but we're good. Fucker. I was quick enough that it grabbed the thing when I got to the door, but I wasn't quick enough to get through the door myself. Let's just say that was intentional. Yeah, let's just go with that. I just had a bad feeling about that run. I wish that was the case, but... I don't know what happened there. At the top. I heard her up there somewhere. know, when this episode started, the first couple of runs, I was feeling pretty confident. But that has very quickly gone downhill. One of the simplest enemies, but yet I almost always get hit by one. Pulled that off, but I did. How in the fuck did I miss these? That one I think I couldn't get to though, actually. Yeah, that one had that in the way. Okay, that's fine. That's understandable, but this one, there's no reason I should have missed. Oh. sacrifice this level. Down when it got shot. Oh, but it's dead. Awesome. I just crushed the paste and the ruby. I don't know how much longer I want to keep attempting Spelunky, because at this rate, it's just not happening. I think the farthest I've gotten in any run was like the second or third level of the ice caves, and at that point I was so screwed I had no chance to get to the end no matter what. I'm normally over 10,000 leaving this level. Holy shit. Oh, that's not... not what you want to run into right away. Will I even be able to hit that spider without pissing off that shopkeeper up above? Worked. course she's up there. Why did I just try to look at a map? There's no map in this game. As well go out in a blaze of glory. Why is it so fucking hard for me to do these? I can't get up to where I wanted to anyway now, can I? Nope. I was gonna say, is that the problem? Do I just need to be quiet while I'm playing? But I mean, majority of the time I am anyway, because I'm. It's no secret I'm not good at commentary. bring this with me. So if we have another level like that one where it was either direction had the arrow things, I can trigger one of them without having to worry. Brought her to the exit. That was on me, though. I was not paying attention to where I was going. Single one of them. Are you kidding me? Okay. Still no sacrifice yet. And that may not seem like a big deal, but that sacrifice thing, that cup is gonna be very useful if I want to. If I want to get far in this, I think. Because it's a nice way to get health back. I wish that timing had been intentional, but it really wasn't. An altar there. I am very surprised I didn't get killed there. Oh, come on. Really? You fucker. I kinda had that coming, though. I was getting a little too cocky there. Found that key, I wasn't doing so bad that time around. I mean, it wasn't like I was doing great, but it wasn't terrible. God, I hate when I do that stupid shit. Eventually, I'll learn not to do those things. But apparently, I haven't learned it just yet. Maybe it's just a pipe dream, but one of these days I'd like to get back to the fucking ice caves. Oh man, I don't know what the hell's going on with me. Like, I know a lot of it is this game is just extremely unforgiving, but it can't be that much of that. A lot of it is just I'm not good at this. Like that, there's no reason I should have run into that spider. I wasn't paying attention to what I was doing. Like, I could come up with excuses all day as to why things go bad, but 90% of the time it's just me not being good at the game. Not like this stuff that I'm dying to is like real hard things to avoid or anything. It's just me making dumb mistakes. And I think that's the worst part about it, is that it's stuff that I shouldn't be getting killed by. I wasn't running, so my jump wasn't far enough to reach the spider, so I just landed in front of it and got hit. Sacrifice. Damn it. Because once you get to the jungle levels, it's a little bit more difficult to do the sacrificing. These levels are always the easiest for it. If I could sacrifice a scorpion. Probably won't get a chance to find out. It'll probably kill me. 10. Okay, so I guess it's any living thing, huh? What about the skulls from the skeletons that come to life? Because you can destroy the body, but the skull is the part that came to life. He turned around just as I was about to jump on him. Okay, that's it for this one. Thank you everybody for watching. Oh yeah, see that? Total deaths, 386. I haven't made it to the end once. That just shows you I'm not good at this. Let me see. Player stats. Plays 386, deaths 386, wins 0, average score 14,957, best score 72,900. I wish it would show you the farthest you've made it. I think you can see that on the leaderboard, right? Level 3-2 is the farthest I made it. Okay, that's it for this one. Thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and as always, I'll see you in the next one.